Hi, I'm Christopher Barrat, and I've worked for over 20 years in business and 17 years in consultancy, speaking all over the world and helping people to just be more effective in the way they deal with each other and the way they deal with themselves. So in terms of career, I started in selling actually, hard selling, door to door, and then slightly softer hard selling in Australia, working for Xerox. Then I came back to the UK, worked for a big blue chip company, doing all sorts of commercial roles, whether it be selling, marketing, procurement, leadership in Europe, and then I was a director of procurement. And then in 2001, I gave it all up and started my own business with a friend, helping people to learn more about leadership, more about communication, and more about sort of the whole management and commercial skills area. So with that experience, what I've done is brought together that hard business experience and management and leadership experience with a lot of the soft stuff, how humans interact, how people interact, how teams interact, and combining those two in an effective way to really help people in the real world make sense of themselves and each other. One of the interesting things to me about having worked in procurement and also having done lots of selling is when I teach selling skills, I'm teaching it from a procurement perspective. So many people approach sales from you do this and you do that. When you sit on the other side of the table, when you see these people coming to you, you suddenly see a very, very different aspect. And I think it's incredibly helpful for salespeople to understand how procurement people think. What are their tactics? What are their skills? What are their feelings? How do they connect to the business? And once salespeople have that insight, they are remarkably more effective. When I'm talking to people about change, I'm really focused on individuals. And strange enough, I'm focused on individuals on their journey, which is often not fun. When I approach change, I think one of the biggest things is to get people to understand you are going to go through stuff, and at times you're going to feel ineffective or unsure or worried, and managing people through that process, being realistic. So instead of telling people it's going to be amazing, you're all going to be lovely, actually telling them it's going to be tough and this is how you manage the ups and downs of change. So take it from a human point of view, take it from a feelings point of view, and take it from an effectiveness point of view, and that seems to work really well. If you want to be the best team in the world, it's really simple. There's a kind of golden triangle. At one corner, there's agreed goals. Really agreed goals. You know all the terms, you're understanding them. The next corner, there's proactive communication. So not just good communication, proactive. How are we doing something rather than what are we doing? And at the top, diversity. You've got to use diversity. You've got to move from just understanding each other to understanding and adapting to each other to get the most out of them. If you do those three things, you will be the best team in the world, no doubt.